Xerneas is back in 5-star raids, and its shiny is officially available in Pokemon Go for the very first time. And just like my Yveltal video, this video is not gonna end until I get the shiny form. So, let's get into our very first raid and see what we can do, and we'll talk about Xerneas and see how actually viable it is in Pokemon Go. Alright, so we are hopping into our very first Xerneas raid right here, and now let's talk about Xerneas and how, like, useful it is in Pokemon Go. Now, as far as a PvP side of things, Xerneas is really good. It is ranked 13th in the Go Battle League, as far as in the Master League, that is, with the moves Tackle, Close Combat, and Moonblast. Now, as far as PvE goes, it's not a very useful Pokemon because it's a primarily fairy type only, and the only fairy type move it gets is Moonblast, so it's not even a very good fairy type Pokemon. It's useful in other ways, like in PvP only. But of course, to be useful in PvP, you need to have this thing maxed out. So you gotta be doing, why am I using a Lugia? I didn't even check my team. So, to be able to use this thing in the Master League, of course, you're going to have to max this out. So, that takes a whole lot of XL candies. And now, I'm sure everyone knows because I'm a little bit late to get into this video. But, of course, the Hundo CPs are going to be 2160 non-weather boosted and weather boosted 2701. The same as Yveltal, actually. Which we got a Hundo on in that. Alright, so the very first Xerneas of the video goes down. Let's hope that this goes a little bit longer than my Yveltal video, which was literally 2 raids to get the shiny. Heck, this is, I might even get my shiny on the very first raid. Who knows? Ooh, 9 rare candies. Love that. Let's go to the summary. We get 15 balls. Let's see what we got. No shiny. 2677. That one's not going to be too bad, actually. And it's weather boosted, so that is pretty amazing, honestly. But on to the next one, and we'll talk more about Xerneas. All right, so we're back in our second raid, and we're going to talk counters for Xerneas, because Xerneas is a straight fairy type. So its weaknesses are going to be poison and steel types. So some of the top counters that you're going to want to use is Mega Gengar, Mega Beedrill, you got Mega Caesar, Mega Aggron. Any of those Mega forms are going to be good counters, but to be honest, you don't want to really use Megas for countering. You want to use Megas to get more candies. So the Mega you're going to want to use is Mega Altaria, because Mega Altaria is a fairy type, and you get more candy that way. But as far as normal counters, you got Metagross, you got Nidalee, you got Dialga, Roserade, Pokemon like that. That are going to be some of your top counters for Xerneas. Anything poison or steel type is going to do the job for you, to be honest. All right, Xerneas 2 goes down. Let's see if we can pull a Yveltal and get it on our second raid. That would be... it'd make my job really easy, to be honest, but let's see. 10,000 XP. We got 15 balls again. Shiny! Not going to be the shiny. CP is going to be 2623. Weather boosted. Not going to be that good. On to the next. Okay, so going back to the usefulness of Xerneas, the highest DPS Pokemon, like, moveset for Xerneas is Tackle and Giga Impact at 14.7 damage per second. The damage per second it puts out with a fairy type move, Moonblast, the fastest, is Tackle and Moonblast at 13.1 damage per second. So that's why I was talking about how it is literally not useful as a fairy type, as you can tell by the damage per second on the actual fairy type move, the one fairy type move that it actually gets. So yeah, Xerneas, fairy type, not good. Non-fairy typing, pretty good. Ranked 13th in the Master League. Very useful to have. And Xerneas number 3 goes down. CP was like 26 something. I don't exactly know. I think I saw it. I could be wrong though. 3 rare candies, blah, blah, blah. 10,000 XP, 13 balls, shiny. And it's not gonna be shiny. Yep, 2631, not gonna be good. On to the next again. Also, last thing about Xerneas is that it will be available until October 20th, and then we're gonna get Giratina. It's one or the other. I don't know if it's altered form or origin form. I just know we're getting both of them at some point, but I think we're only getting each of them for a week, and then we're moving into the month of November, which November we will get even more raid Pokemon, hopefully some more meta relevant Pokemon, and hopefully I can keep doing videos like this, because honestly, I enjoy doing videos like this. One, it gets me shinies, and two, it gets me a lot of candies for some legendary Pokemon. So I hope you guys enjoy. Be sure to like and comment and subscribe if you do enjoy this, so I can keep doing them, just so I know that you guys are actually enjoying this, because obviously if you guys aren't enjoying it, then it's probably not worth my time to do it. Let me know if you guys have managed to get shiny Xerneas yet, and if you've gotten a hundo, let me know if you've gotten one of those, because to be honest, I would love for this Pokemon to be my very first shundo. I think I would just end my career at that point once I get a shundo, especially if it's a legendary. Career done. I'm just done at that point. Raid number 4 goes down. Let's see if this one's going to be the shiny. Go to the summary and encounter shiny. 2102, not gonna be good either. On to the next, at least I get candy. I can't remember if this is Xerneas 5 or 6. I think I'm leaning towards 6, to be honest, but I'm not entirely sure. But Xerneas 5 or 6 goes down. There'll be a counter on the screen on the YouTube video after it's edited, so whatever I said on screen, that's what number we're on. Please be shiny. I wanna be done already. We only get 12 balls. Let's see if it's shiny, please. Oh, no. 2137 is not even good. I've run out of talking points too. That's why that one was just straight to the end. On to the next. I'm just gonna start transferring a shiny every time it's not shiny. So that way we are making sacrifices to the shiny gods to give us another shiny. I think that's what must happen, and that's what we're gonna do. Shiny Xerneas demands sacrifices, and I will give those sacrifices to Shiny Xerneas. Alright, so this one is actually Xerneas number 6, and if this one's not shiny, like I said, we are making a sacrifice to the shiny gods to hopefully bring us Shiny Xerneas. But if this one is shiny, we don't have to! Please! Let this be shiny. All right, let's see if this is going to be shiny or if we're making a sacrifice. 10,000 XP. Go on to the summary. We get 12 balls. Shiny! We are making a sacrifice here. 2660. That's actually not that bad. But either way, a sacrifice must be made. And the shiny that we are sacrificing is going to be a Lillipup. I am perfectly okay with this. Say hello to Arceus for me. Goodbye. On to the next raid. All right, so this is Xerneas number 7. And since we sacrificed the Lillipup to Arceus to give us the shiny Xerneas, this is gonna be the raid. Obviously, if the video doesn't end in the next minute, obviously, I didn't get the shiny. But you know what? This one is gonna be a shiny because we made the sacrifice. We did what we had to do. I didn't enjoy it, but we did it because we had to. This one will be shiny. Xerneas number 7. Will our sacrifice be in vain? I sure hope not, because Lillipup did not die for this. Summary, we get 15 balls. Shiny. Lillipup died for nothing. On to the next. All right, and who's going to be the next sacrifice? It's going to be... Oh, man, we transferred one of this last time. I did a transfer challenge. Okay, it's definitely got to be a shiny now, because... Ooh, that's a good one. Xerneas number 8 goes down. We have sacrificed the Dino for this. And Dino's actually a good shiny, so I really hope this one wasn't in vain. Because we're already on 8, 13 balls, please. Come on, bro. 2144, that's actually going to be a really good one since the hundo's 2160. But it's not what we're looking for. On to the next. And what shiny are we going to get rid of now? Let's see. Boom. Oh no, that's such a good shiny too. Oh, it's from Calm Day though. Oh well, transfer. Xerneas number 9 goes down. 10,000 XP again, yay. 16 balls, shiny.
When will this torture end?
Well, trying to transfer another shiny and do another raid. Getting real sick and tired of this already. And the next shiny we're getting rid of is gonna be a... Sveal. I have plenty of these. That doesn't hurt too bad. Could be a whole lot worse. We need to add some more Pokemon to that graveyard though, that challenge. You know, some days just really go your way when you raid. Sometimes it takes one, sometimes it takes two raids. As you saw in my Yveltal video, I got 2 back-to-back on my second and third raid of the video. Now, going on to 10 raids, and we have not gotten a shiny. Not even a 98. Not even anything good. It is just not my day, guys. And I'm getting real tired battling this little deer thing with swords for legs. Because to be honest, that's exactly what it is. It's a deer thing with swords for legs. Just look at it. But be shiny. Please? Okay, so that was number 10. We have sacrificed 3 Pokemon now? 4 Pokemon? I think 4. 3. I don't really know. Whatever it said on screen, I don't rightfully know. But 16 balls. Shiny! I was honestly, even if this one wasn't shiny, I was just gonna call it. That was just gonna be it. Because I was tired of doing this raid. And I was gonna be like, you know what? We'll continue this on stream. Which, to be honest, we might still do some raids on stream. Who knows? But 10 raids. We got a 2136 shiny Xerneas. Check the IVs on it. That's pretty good, not gonna lie. I will take it. That's probably one of the better ones that we have gotten, to be honest. Yeah, minus this 2144. This was actually the best one that we got. But honestly, it only has one more attack than my shiny one. But that's gonna do it for the video, obviously. I finally got my shiny. Took 10 raids. Granted, that's over odds because it's 1 in 20. Either way, I appreciate you guys so much for watching. If you did make it this far, claps. I appreciate y'all. Thank you guys. Be sure to tune into the YouTube streams. Be sure to like and subscribe, all those things. Ring that bell so you get notified whenever I do post and whenever I do end up going live, because I might do some more raids on stream. Who knows? I could use some help. If you guys enjoyed, like I said, like, comment, subscribe, ring that bell, all those good things, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.